Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the EduSat Network. Our today's topic of discussion is development and planning in India. For this topic and for this discussion, we have with us in the studio Dr. Rajiv Shukla, and he is a coordinator for the PhD program at the Indian Institute of Foreign Trade, New Delhi. And I would also like to tell you that he has over 7 years of experience in teaching and research, and we are privileged to have him here. Thank you for coming, sir.
Thank you. Hello, friends. In the previous lecture, we had discussed about the macroeconomic fundamentals, what is the meaning of GDP, GNP, NNP, NDP. These are the basic concepts of macroeconomic policy. Today, we are going to discuss about the development and planning in India, which is a very crucial and important topic for the all part. Either if you are preparing for the competitive exam, then you have to know about the what is the development and planning in India from the independence. As you are aware that if you want to achieve a goal, if you want to achieve a sustainable growth, then you have to a plan. Then you have to approach a systematic plan. If you want to your nation in the high distinction, then you have a proper plan, proper approach, proper systematic a plan, whether with the help of this plan you can achieve, you can distinct your nation in the high priority. So after get independence, there was need to a systematic approach for the fulfillment of sustainable growth for our country. So in the previously, though the planning commission has been established in the year of 1950, but if you think that the sum of the period from the pre-independence in 1938, the National Planning Commission by Indian National Congress, the Bombay Plan, the Gandhian Plan in 1944, Pupil Plan in 1945, by Post-War Reconstruction Commission of India, and after that the Sarvodaya Plan in 1950 by Jai Prakash Narayan. So if you think that the planning only be established in 1950, then it may not correct. The planning may be the planning already established from the pre-independence, as I said, in 1938, Indian National Congress, the Bombay Plan and Gandhian Plan in 1944. And after that, as I said, Sarvodaya Plan in 1950 by Jai Prakash Narayan. So there is a lot of criticism also ki why the plan is being established for the part of nation's growth. Why is it necessary? Why is it so important? If you think whether the plan, if you have not a plan, if you have not a sustainable plan approach, then you may get a sustainable growth, then you may get a high distinction for our country. So is it possible? No. If you have to achieve in a single core a goal, then you have to a systematic plan. And for if we are talking about the nation or the country, then you have to have very systematic plan approach. So here is a development and planning in India. As the topic suggests, before I am going to discuss what is the plan, what is the systematic plan, what is the development, what is the planning in India from 1950 onwards, before I start, I would like to kind your attention for the part of what is a plan and how is it necessary or why is it necessary for our country or any approach. So a plan is a deliberate attempt to spell out how the resource of a country should be put to use it. A plan is a deliberative attempt to spell out how the resources of a country should be put to use it. For the part of country, as I said, that you have to necessary a systematic plan approach, whether the approach, what the approach can done, the approach, resources of a country should be put to use it. We have so many resources. As you read in many of journals articles that India have many resources. So plan is a deliberate attempt to how to resource of a country should be put to use it. And it has some general and specific goals. Every plan has some specific goals, general goals, which are to be achieved within a specific period of time, whether the time is the 1 year or whether the time is the 5 year. The general goals of plan are growth, modernization, full employment, self-realization and equity. As you are much aware about these facts, that these are general plans. Every nation, not in India, every nation wants to a higher growth, modernization, full employment, self-reliance and equity. But all plans may not give equal importance to all of them. Sometimes a plan is not only a goal for only a general purpose, but a plan has maybe a specific goals. Each plan can have some specific goals like improvement of agriculture, improvement of industry, improvement of modernization techniques of agriculture, maybe. The some specific goals, whether if you have a specific goal, then you have to carry a more orientation, then you have to carry a more focus on this approach. But if you have in general, as in a general manner, if you have so many goals, if you have in general goals, then you have to carry in, put your efforts in every corner. But if you have a specific goals, then you have to consider your approach only a specific. So it may be a very much useful that if you have a specific goals. That's why Indian Planning Commission or the Indian Planning, maybe sometimes he approached only for agriculture. Sometimes he approached poverty reduction. Sometimes plan approach better industrialization. Sometimes approach for modernization. So if you have a specific goal, then you have to consider your approach in a very appropriate manner. So now, historical review of planning. In India, just after the attainment of independence, the first Prime Minister Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru set up a planning commission in India in 1950. As I said, as I covered in my earlier PPT, as I said that the planning may be started in 1950, but the pre-independence has also started for the some planning, as I said, the Bombay plan, Gandhian plan. But as I said, ki if you have a systematic approach, so this is the line of the systematic approach, whatever the Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru has set up the planning commission in 1950 to assess the country's needs of material capital and human resources and to formulate economic plans for their more balanced and effective utilize. We have so many resources, we have so human power, as you know, we are 1025 crore, we have one Arab, but we have two Arab hands. This is called a human ability, this is called the human power. We are not in a drawback that we have more than 1000 crore. This is your power, that we have two Arab hands also. So for the planning approach, for the planning commission consultation, the main aim is to assess the country needs of material capital and human resource and to formulate economic plans for their more balanced and effective utilization. Sansadhan bahut sare hain, prakritik sansadhan ke alawa bhi humare paas human resource bhi hai. Lekin isko capitalization karna, isko aur valuable banana, iske liye ek bahut ek simit plan aur ek sugam plan ki avashyakta hoti hai. और पंडित जवाहरलाल नेहरू द्वारा राष्ट्रीय प्लानिंग कमीशन 1950 में संगठित बनाने का श्रेय उनको जाता है. और इसके कारण सबसे ज़्यादा इम्पैक्ट ये थे कि जो रिसोर्सेज हैं, जो आपके ह्यूमन रिसोर्सेज हैं, जो आपके कैपिटल फॉर्मेशन है, जो आपके नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज हैं, उनका बेहतर यूज हो सके, उस संसाधन का जिसको आप हिंदी में कह सकते हैं विदोहन हो सके, एक उचित विदोहन हो सके. सो द फर्स्ट फाइव ईयर प्लान कमिंस इन 1950-51 वॉज फॉलोड बाई अ सीरीज ऑफ फाइव ईयर प्लान्स. So in the next slide, you can find how the 1950, what is the planning commission's objective and how is it fulfilled or not fulfilled from the 1950 onwards. So if you see the next slide, planning commission of India, the planning commission was set up in March 1950 and a resolution of the, with the resolution of the government of India. So the economy of the India is based in economic approach of the 5 years plan. Developed, executed and monitored by the planning commission with the ex-chairmanship of Prime Minister and the deputy chairman of Monteng Singh Aluwalia is now a currently deputy chairman of planning commission. So with the help of chairmanship of Prime Minister and with the help of Monteng Singh Aluwalia, which is who is the currently deputy chairman of this commission, the 5 year plans. Basically, an Indian Planning Commission constituted a 5 year plans for India's growth, for India's prospect. What is the objective of Planning Commission of India? When you set a commission, when you set a committee, so there was some objective also there. What are you going to explore? What are you going to achieve? So you have to an objective. So what is the objective of the Planning Commission of India? Here are the Planning Commission set out the following four long-term objective of planning. The four long-term, what is the four long-term? To increase production to the maximum possible extent so as to achieve higher level of national and per capita income. We had discussed in previous lecture about the national income and per capita income, and most of the guys are maybe aware that if you achieve a higher national income, if you achieve a higher per capita income, which is the sign of your national growth, which is the sign of your nation aapka pragati kar raha hai, you are in right path. So first one, to increase production to maximum possible extent so as to achieve higher level of national and per capita income. The second one objective is to achieve full employment. Sometimes it seems a very hyperbolic to achieve full employment. Is it possible or not? But you can try it. To reduce inequality of income and wealth. This is the main cause whether the India suffers some inequality of income. जिसको कहते हैं आय का असमान वितरण. किसी के पास काफ़ी पैसा है, किसी के पास कम है, और कुछ कोई गरीब है तो कोई बहुत गरीब है. तो इस चीज़ को, टू रिड्यूस इनइक्वलिटीज ऑफ इनकम एंड वेल्थ, द थर्ड वन ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ प्लानिंग कमीशन इन इंडिया. एंड द फोर्थ वन, एंड टू सेट अप अ सोशलिस्ट सोसाइटी बेस्ड ऑन इक्वलिटी एंड जस्टिस एंड एब्सेंस ऑफ एक्सप्लॉयटेशन. एक सर्वमान समाज की स्थापना, एक न्याय संगत समाज की स्थापना, जहां पर शोषण, एब्सेंस ऑफ एक्सप्लाइटेशन, जहां पर शोषण की अनुपस्थिति हो या उसकी जगह ना हो, ये चार ऑब्जेक्टिव प्लानिंग कमीशन ने निर्धारित किए थे अपने स्थापना के समय. एंड 5 ईयर्स प्लान्स ओवर रिव्यू, अगर आप एक ओवर रिव्यू देखेंगे, देन यू फाइंड एवरी 5 ईयर प्लान्स हैज सम स्पेसिफिक एंड ऑल्सो अ जनरल अप्रोच, बट एवरी 5 ईयर प्लान्स have in a same part a strategy of planned approach to economic development, to form a strategy to plan approach to economic development. Every plan, or you can say every 5 year plan, has some specific approach, but even then the strategy of the same, the plan of the same, the approach of the same, whether you want to achieve a higher agriculture growth, you are trying about the higher agriculture growth, if you are trying the higher industrial growth, the strategy, the plan, then the process is approximately same. Planning Commission is responsible for the formulation of 5 year plan. Objective, as I discussed, growth, employment, self reliance and social justice. Also, Planning Commission is also responsible for continual watch on trend and adjustment. For the economic point of view, there is a very fluctuation situation in every day. Every day, the conditions, the assumptions may be changed. So, Planning Commission have to undergo for the continual watch on trend and adjustment. For the 5 year, 5 year is a long period. So, may it be possible, the conditions of the market, the conditions of the exchange rates, may it be changed. So for this prospect, Planning Commission have to continually watch of the trend and prospects in markets, in trends, in exchange rates, and the process of fluctuations. Systematic observation of technical, economic and social data. Also, Planning Commission have to observe about the systematical observation of technical, economic and social data. When you captured a economic growth structure, then you find a systematic observation of technical, economic and social data. Planning Commission ka ek dayitva yah bhi tha ki jab aap kisi cheez ko approach kar rahe hain, kisi cheez ki आउटपुट निकाल रहे हैं, तो उसका भी एक सिस्टमेटिक ऑब्जर्वेशन हो, एनालिसिस हो. ये 5 ईयर प्लान का ओवर रिव्यू है. नाउ द फर्स्ट प्लान, एज वी डिस्कस, द प्लानिंग कमीशन वॉज सेट अप ऑन इन 1950 एंड द फर्स्ट प्लान वॉज इंट्रोड्यूस इन 1951 टू 1956. The first Indian Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru presented the first 5-year plan to the Parliament of India on December 8, 1951. The first plan sought to get the country's economy out of the cycle of poverty. At that time, 1951, we were suffering for the high poverty. The plan addressed mainly the agrarian sector. At least 75% to above population. Today we have now 60% population on agrarian sector, but at that time 75% to above, including investment in dams, irrigation. Agriculture sector was hit hardest by the partition and needed urgent attention. As you are aware, that at that time we have a partition. So partition hits the hardest by agrarian sector and needed urgent attention. विभाजन के दौर के बाद काफी कुछ ऐसी समस्याएं उस समय उत्पन्न हुई थी कि आपके किसी प्लानिंग अप्रोच को एग्रीकल्चर सेक्टर पर सबसे ज्यादा फोकस की आवश्यकता थी. So the plan addressed mainly the agrarian sector, including investment in dams and irrigations. The total plan budget at that time of 206.8 billion was allocated to 7 broad areas. At that time, Planning Commission's total plan budget of 206.8 billion was allocated to 7 broad areas. The first plan mein total जो बजट का एलोकेशन था वो 206.8 बिलियन था और इसको 7 सेक्टर्स में बांटा गया था एंड वाज एलोकेटेड टू 7 सेक्टर्स एरिया. द फर्स्ट वन इज इरिगेशन एंड एनर्जी. द टोटल एलोकेशन ऑफ बजट का 27.2% इज ओनली फॉर इरिगेशन एंड एनर्जी. द 17.4% फॉर द पार्ट ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड कम्युनिटी डेवलपमेंट. 24% for transport and communications, 8.4% industry, 16.64% for the social services and land rehabilitation, and other 2.5%. So the major thrusting areas are agriculture, irrigation and energy development, and social services. Which was the most important key issues at that time? As we are badly hit by partition. The target growth rate was 2.1%. In every plan, we set a target growth which we are trying to achieve. Every plan. When you see the earlier slides and we come to forward from 1st to 9, 10, 11th plan, now we are approach the 12th year plan from 2012 to 2017. So you can see, you may see the target growth rate in every plan we can set. We set, because without, if you cannot set, then how can you achieve? So first you set your growth rate, first you set your the goal, then you have to try for to achieve this goal. So the target growth rate was 2.1% annual gross domestic product GDP growth. And the achieved growth rate was 3.6%. So as you see, if the target growth rate is only at 2.1%, which was our goal, but we achieved growth rate was 3.6%. Definitely, it was a successful plan because we achieved a more growth rate instead of targeted. So during the first 5-year plan, the net domestic product went up by 15%. In a previous lecture, we had already discussed about what is the GDP, what is the net domestic product. So most of the guys who have seen the previous lecture or you can see on the recorded version, then you find what is the meaning of net domestic and the GDP. So during the first 5-year plan, the net domestic product went up by 15%. At that time, the monsoon was good and there was relatively high crop yields. As you are aware, and very soon that our agriculture is totally depend on monsoon, on weather you can say. So at that time the monsoon was good and there were relatively high yields, boosting exchange reserves and the per capita income, which increased by 8%. National income increased more than per capita income. due to rapid population growth. This was also a good sign, and many irrigation projects were initiated during this period. The most famous name, Bhakra Dam and Hirakund Dam, was started at that time. The World Health Organization with the Indian government addressed children's health and reduce infant mortality. This was also a very important factor at that time and indirectly contributing to population growth. So here you can see the first approach by the Planning Commission of India to set the national growth, to sustain the national growth, to sustain the parameters of Indian, our country, with the help of this plan, with the process of this plan. And in the first plan from 1951-1956, here are the targeted and what we achieved. At the end of the plan period in 1956, the sum of the Indian institutes of IITs were started as major technical institutions. So there was a most constructive development in the first plan. If you are asking about the development of first plan, if you are asking about the merit of first plans, so as you seen in previous slide, that the project of Hirakund and Bhakra Dawal was started at that time. And at the end of the plan period, 1956, the Indian Institute of Technology was also started. University Grant Commission was set up to take care of funding and take measure to strengthen the higher education in the country. UGC was also established. Contract were signed to start 5 steel plants. However, these plants did not come into existence until the until this period of the end, but contracts were signed. So in at a glance, if you can see, plan was a successful as the plan objective and targeted growth, or the you can say targeted area were filled. Achieved growth was more than the target. Total allocation of the budget is 2069 crores. Actual expenditure 1960 crores. Net domestic product increased by 15% and per capita income by 8%. Here I would like to bring your kind attention. The most of the guys who are preparing for the exam or the competitive exam, you can see or you can ask ki why the government expend more and more. Or you can say we are a deficit budgeting. We have deficit budgeting. There are three types of budget. One is adhik jyada jyada aap budget banate hain, ek santulit budget banate hain aur ek ghate ka budget banate hain. And our government follow the deficit budgeting. Why? Kyun kharch jyada hai, income kam hai? Government, why government prefer a deficit budgeting? जिसको हिंदी में आप कह सकते हैं घाटे की वित्त व्यवस्था. व्हाई गवर्नमेंट प्रेफर? बिकॉज ऑफ एज द रैपिड पॉपुलेशन ग्रोथ द गवर्नमेंट हैव टू एक्सपेंड मोर एंड मोर, एंड गवर्नमेंट हैव टू प्रोवाइड मोर सोशल सर्विसेज टू ऑल द ह्यूमन बींग्स, टू ऑल द सिटीजन्स ऑफ इंडिया. इवन दे आर पेइंग फॉर इनकम टैक्स, even they are paying for indirect tax or not, but you have to ensure your social services, your position in the form of government, and you have to provide all the facilities to all the citizens. So that expenditure of government side is always increase, and the income side it is less than of expenditure. You can see at the time of presenting a budget by the finance minister, hamesha expenditure ko pehle dikhaya jata hai. You can see either the new government may be presented in next 2 months. You can see first expenditure, where the government want to expand, what are the facilities government want to provide to all the citizens, what are the expenditure where to government have to expend for the social services cause. First expenditure, and after the completion of expenditure part and the total gross amount, here is the expenditure, total expenditure where the government want to constitute or expand in 1 year, and after that, what is the proportion of income? And you can find the total gross of expenditure is always less in comparison to total income what the government earned in the next current year, always, because government have to ensure the facilities, social services to every citizens of India. Now, second plan, in 1956 to 1961, this plan also called a Mahalomonist model, is the Indian statistical Prashanta Chandra Mahalonovich in 1953. The second 5 year plan focused on industry, especially heavy industry. Here you look, a focus only a specific object on industry. Also, some more specific, especially heavy industry. It may not mean that the second 5 year plan did not get approach for the agriculture or the industry. It had. But as I said, if you have choose a specific object of the specific industry, then you have to ensure your efforts more in appropriate manner. Domestic production of industrial product was increased, particularly in the development of public sector. The plan followed the Mahalonovich model, an economic development model developed by the Indian statistician Prashanta Chandra Mahalonovich. It used the exciting art techniques of operations and research, as well as the novel applications of a statistical model developed at the Indian Statistical Institute. The plan assumed a closed economy in which the main trading activity would be centered on importing capital goods. The plan assumed a closed economy. What is the meaning of closed economy? Most of the guys may be surprised. What is the closed economy? Closed economy means there is no international trade. If you are asking about the closed economy and the open economy, the only differentiate. The closed economy, there is no international trade or the trade beyond the boundaries of your country, or you can say the trade, there is no trade beyond the boundaries of your country. And in, we are in now in open economy. In open economy, you can say that you have international trade. And with the formulation of open economy, the concept is we are integrated our economy to the world economy. We cross the border for the trading. And they can cross their border for trading. There is no restriction, or the restriction may be a more liberalized. But at the second plan approach, the plan assumed a closed economy in which the main trading activity would be centered on importing capital goods. Some hydroelectric power project at that time at 5 steel mills at Bhilai Durgapur, it is a very renowned name. And most of the guys who are very much aware about the general knowledge things, that lots of the times of the Bhilai and Durgapur is a very renowned name for the steel mills, and Rourkela were established at that time. Coal production was increased. Today, and if you are asking about the coal production capacity for today, so you can say today we are some insufficient about the theme of coal production, about the task of coal production, but at that time coal production was increased. More railway lines were added in the northeast. The Atomic Energy Commission, it was a very important thing. The Atomic Energy Commission was formed in 1957 with Homi J. Bhava at the first chairman. It is also a very renowned name, everybody knows. The Homi J. Bhava was the first chairman of the Atomic Energy Commission, was formed in 1957. The Tata Institute of Fundamental Research was established as a research institute. But unfortunately, plan could not be implemented fully because acute shortage of foreign exchange. You can't say that the plan was not successful. It is. But little bit. It could not be implemented fully because At that time, we had not sufficient foreign exchange. Today, we are in economic open economy. There is no restriction to trade to establish a market in India or to you or our citizens or the our channel or the partners of trading can establish a market in India, and we can establish our market in rest of the world. But at that time, this model assumed a closed economy, and it could not be implemented it fully because of acute stage shortage of foreign exchange. The third plan is from 1961 to 1966. The third plan stressed on agriculture and improving production of rice. Again, the third plan focused on agriculture and improving production of rice is a specific. The Sino-Indian war led to inflation and the priority was shifted to price stabilization. When this the third plan started, the approach is stressed on agriculture and improving production of rice. But at the same time, you are most of the guys aware that some 1962 China was more aggression. So the focus shifted to priority was shifted to price stabilization, because at that time the inflation rise up. Even then, the construction of dams constituted, many cement and fertilizers plants were also built, and Punjab begins production and abundance of wheat. Many primary schools concepts were started in rural areas. The most important factor is also started, panchayat election were started, and the states were given more development responsibilities. With the help of panchayat election, you can achieve, you can choose your motive to build, to reconstruct the rural areas. That's why the panchayat has been established, and the panchayat election were started, and the state were given more development responsibilities. State electricity boards and state secondary education boards were formed. All of you know about the state secondary education, at that time were formed. State road transportation corporation were formed, and local and road building became a state responsibilities. Before this plan, all the responsibilities were carried by the central government, but at that time state road transportation corporation were formed and local road building and become a state responsibility. Now the state have to look about the infrastructure development for the road transportation or the for the local road building. It's the state's responsibility at that time. Total proposed outline play is the 11,600 crore. The situation at that time, rate of growth of agriculture was the main limiting factor in India's economic development for the part of third plan, and objective change to defense development because of Indo-China and Indo-Pak wars. As I said, first focused, we have to top priority to agriculture with equal emphasis on development of basic industries, but focus we are changed immediately. And it's changed to from agriculture to defense development. Why? Because at that time Indo-China, Indo-Pak wars, there was very hearted phase for our nations, and targeted growth which we set at that time is 5.6 and we achieved only a 2.84. It's a complete failure, because the heightened obstacle was there. The first is Indo-China in 1962. China was on aggression and the Indo-Pak wars. So complete failure in reaching the target due to unforeseen circumstances at the third plan. And also at the last of 1965, the severe drought is also formed. Sukhe ki sthiti bahut bhari 1965 इस प्लान के एंड में शुरू हो गई थी. हम वी हैड ऑलरेडी स्ट्रगल्ड अबाउट द पोस्ट फैक्टर्स ऑफ इंडियन वार्स, इंडिया पाक वार्स एंड इंडिया चाइना, एंड एट द सेम टाइम द सीवियर ड्रॉट आर ऑल्सो. सो द कंप्लीट फेलियर अबाउट द थर्ड प्लान 1961 to 1966. आफ्टर दैट थ्री एनुअल प्लान्स, और यू कैन से हॉलीडे फॉर थ्री ईयर्स. देयर वॉज नो फाइव ईयर प्लान आफ्टर इमीडिएटली थर्ड प्लान. द थ्री एनुअल प्लान्स बिकॉज द मेन रीजन इज दैट कि वी हैड सफर्ड सो मैनी फ्लक्चुएशन एट दैट टाइम ड्यू टू द वार सीजन, ड्यू टू सीवियर ड्रॉट. सो वी पोस्टपोन द फाइव ईयर अप्रोच एंड वी कंस्टिट्यूटेड थ्री एनुअल प्लान्स फॉर सस्टेन आवर इकोनॉमीज ग्रोथ, और यू कैन रीअसेंबल आवर इकोनॉमीज ग्रोथ. इट वॉज वेरी नेसेसरी एट दैट टाइम. प्रिवेलिंग क्राइसिस इन एग्रीकल्चर एंड सीरियस फूड शॉर्टेज necessities the emphasis on agriculture during the annual plans. During these plans, a whole new agriculture strategy was implemented. During the three annual plans, a whole new agriculture strategy was implemented. It involving widespread distribution of highly yielding varieties of seeds, exceeding use of fertilizers, exploitation of irrigation potential. So during the 3 year plans, we had more focused on agriculture, on the technology of agriculture at that time. And during the annual plans, the economy absorbed the shocks generated during the third plan. As you see, during the third plan, we had unstructured economy due to India-Pak war and India-China war and severe drought. So we were struggling at that time, and through the three annual plan, we are trying to pave the path for the plan growth ahead. And the next fourth plan, 1969 to 1964, the period is 1969 to 64. The proposed plan outlays 24,880 crore. At that time, what is the situation? The large scale poverty and employment. बहुत कॉमन सी बात है कि जब आप किसी एक ऐसे फेज से निकल कर आते हैं, एज यू सीन द थर्ड प्लान इज द मोर ड्रेस्टिक वे, उसके इम्पैक्ट आगे आने वाले कई सालों तक आपको देखने को मिलते हैं. एज वी हैड सफर्ड सो मैनी थिंग्स इन द थर्ड प्लान ड्यू टू वार एंड द सीवियर ड्रॉट, द इम्पैक्ट ऑफ डैट फैक्टर्स वेयर रिजेंबलेंस इन द period of 1969 and 1972-74, large scale poverty and unemployment. So the objective of fourth plan is growth with stability and progressive achievement of self-reliance. The target is 5.5 for growth, or provision of national minimum for weaker section of the community, and you can say garibi hatao, because at that time are large scale poverty. But as I said, some of the hardest consequences at that time due to third year plan approach for the reason of war situations and drought. So we can target it 5.7 growth in fourth plan, and we can achieve only a 3.30% growth. Not failure, but not a sustainable approach, or you can say not a sustainable gain. The Indira Gandhi government were formed in 1969 during the fourth plan. The government nationalized 14 major Indian banks, and the green revolution in India advanced agriculture. What were the policies processed during the three annual year plan at the focused on only agriculture, technology of agriculture, and the same process continue in the form of green revolution in India advanced agriculture. Everybody knows what is the meaning of green revolution. It is called Harit Kranti in the form of Hindi. The advances of the agriculture, the advances of the more technologically agriculture. In addition to the situation in East Pakistan, now independent Bangladesh, was become dire as the Indo-Pakistan war of 1971 and Bangladesh. Liberalization war took place. Funds earmarked for the industrial development had to be used for the war effort. So one thing, if you can see, at that time Indira Gandhi government nationalized 14 major Indian banks, and the Green Revolution, which were processed in the 3 annual plan for the advanced agriculture, and the same thing process in a continuation way in the 4th plan. But in the situation of East Pakistan was become dire as the Indo-Pakistan war of 1977. India also performed the Smiling Buddhas undergo nuclear test in 1974, partially in response to the United States deployment of the 7th Fleet in the Bay of Bengal to warn India again attacking West Pakistan and widening the war. There are so many situations at that time. The fourth one, if you can say, influx of Bangladeshi refugees before and after 1970 Indo-Pak war was an important issue. You can see the increase of unemployment because the influx of most of the refugees, or after the war, it has been decided that some of the refugees came at that time to India, and the unemployment parameter is raised so badly. So these are the issue was an important, very much important to sustain the growth in during the fourth plan, because we had several issue, we had several severe issues. How can we resolve these issues? How can we overcome on these issues? The period of fifth plan, 1974 to 1979, and proposed plan outlay, you can see the every 5 year plan, proposed plan outlay, we also increased. The proposed plan outlay 53,410 crores. And situation, as you see in the fourth plan, the inflation is being rising some more and more. So the situation was so as same, high inflation, hike in all prices, failure of government takeover of the wholesale trade in wheat. And the objective was also same, removal of poverty and attainment of self-reliance. Because we are struggling about the poverty, and it's a chain process. If the unemployment increase, the poverty is also increase, or you can say if you want a rapidly population growth, then the arrow goes to unemployment, and the unemployment arrow goes to poverty. Ek chain process hota hai ki jab aap पॉपुलेशन की ग्रोथ को कंट्रोल नहीं कर पाते हैं, आइदर वो पॉपुलेशन ग्रोथ इन्फ्लक्स हो रिफ्यूजीज की, पॉपुलेशन बढ़ रहा था, पॉपुलेशन जब बढ़ता है अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट राइज कर जाता है, अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट राइज करता है पॉवर्टी राइज कर जाती है, पॉवर्टी राइज करती है डिमांड कम हो जाती है, डिमांड कम हो जाती है प्रोडक्शन कम हो जाता है. चेन प्रोसेस है, इट्स अ सर्किल यू कैन ड्रॉ. इफ द पॉपुलेशन राइज, then the unemployment is also rise, and if the unemployment rises, the poverty is also rising. If the poverty is also rising, the demand is decreasing, and the demand is decreasing, production is also decreasing. If the production is decreasing, then the unemployment, the circle is bound up. There is no need to extra labor. If the production decrease, so there is no need to extra labor. So why the producer engaged the more and more labor? Because there was no demand. So it's a chain process. So that same thing was happened Removal of poverty is the objective of 5th-year plan. We targeted the growth 4.4 and we achieved 3.8% only, not bad. What were the situation at that time? In 1978, this plan terminated by Janata Party. You can see in the next slide, basically the fifth plan was prepared and launched by D.D. Dhar, and it proposed to achieve two main objectives as you have seen, removal of poverty, garibi hatao, and attainment of self-reliance. Stress was laid on employment, poverty alleviation and justice. The plan also focused on self-reliance in agriculture, production and defense. The important factor, Electricity Supply Act was enacted in 1975, which enabled the central government to enter into power generation and transmission. This is one of the act where the central government to enter into power generation, and 1975 it has been established. And in 1978, as you seen, the new Janata Party, the Morarji Desai government, rejected the plan in 1978 due to some unforeseen circumstances that they were supposed that the plan is not have proper approach to fulfillment the achieve a targeted growth or the some distinct area. Now, rolling plan introduced. As you see, in the Janata Party rejected the 5-year plans. If you can see a previous slide, the sixth plan is 5th rolling plan in 1978 reduced, and if you can see the 5th plan is 1974 to 1979. Before a completion of 5th plan, in 1978 the Janata Party and the Morarji Desai government rejected before a year. Now, the rolling plan from 1970 to 1980, not the 6th plan. 2 6th plans, one by the Janata Party during the period 1978 to 1983, focus on enlargement of employment potential in agriculture and allied activities and encouragement to small industry. And the plan were rejected when Congress Party came. So, there was some political war. You can say the plan was rejected when Congress Party came into power. The objective changed to removal of poverty by expanding economy. The objective were also changed. The objective earlier decided is the removal of poverty. When the Congress Party came into power, the objective changed to removal poverty to expanding economy. They were supposed that if you can expand your economy, then you have to create more and more employment for the workers or the citizens. So, they focused for expanding the economic activities. Now, the 6th plan introduced in 1980 to 1985, proposed plan outlay is increased, is the 1,58,710 crores. The situation was also there, high levels of poverty and inflation. Actually, this is the very general parameter. We are also suffering in the same manner. Now, the also a high levels of poverty and inflation at the same time. Why? Because the the 5 years plan, when you decided in the first year ki what you achieved and what you are trying to achieve, rest of the years may be a dramatic situation or may be some drastic situation may be happen in your country. So, when you targeted your growth, when you targeted your area where you can try to achieve, may it be possible it will be changed, or the it definitely change due to some fluctuation of market and due to some unforeseen circumstances. So, the same thing, high level of poverty and inflation was also there. Indian economy made good progress and most of the target fixed were realized. Aimed kiya tha 5.2 and achieved a 5.7 in a 6th plan. We can achieve more what we targeted. In the 6th plan, when Rajiv Gandhi was elected as the Prime Minister, The young Prime Minister aimed for rapid industrial development, especially in the area of information technology. This time, or you can say that the time of Rajiv Gandhi, when he was elected as the Prime Minister, the young Prime Minister aimed to focus more on rapid industrial growth and especially in the area of information technology.
Right. Sorry to interrupt you, sir, but we are getting a question. If you allow,
sure,
we can
sure,
take.
Sure, please.
Yes.
हेलो
जी,
बताइए अपना सवाल पूछिए प्लीज. अपने टेलीविजन का वॉल्यूम कम कर दीजिए. अनफॉर्चुनेटली गॉट डिसकनेक्टेड. प्लीज कॉल अगेन सो वी कैन हियर यू क्लियरली. एंड व्हेनेवर यू कॉल अपने टेलीविजन का वॉल्यूम कम कर दीजिए ताकि हम आपको अच्छे से सुन सकें. सर वी कैन कंटिन्यू.
सो I am discussing when Rajiv Gandhi were elected as the Prime Minister of the young Prime Minister was aimed more to more industrial development, especially in the area of information technology. The Indian National Highway System was introduced at that time. For the first time, and many roadways were widened to accommodate the increasing traffic. At that time, you may see the population growth rapidly increasing. So there is lot of focus for many roads were widened and accommodate the increasing traffic. Tourism also expanded at that time. The sixth plan also marked the beginning of economic liberalization. What is the meaning of liberalization? We have three objectives right now. First is globalization, the second is liberalization, and third is privatization. Or you can say these are the pillars of Indian economy. With the help of globalization, we are integrated our economy to the world economy. With the help of liberalization, we can liberal our trade barriers. We have already more liberalized in trading or the trading partner countries. And for the part of globalization, we are open our borders for the trading countries, ki they can enter in our country and expand the market. We have already decided for the FDI.
Sir,
also.
We are getting a question.
Please.
Yes, is the caller online?
Hello. Good morning, sir.
Good morning. Very good morning. Please, bataiye.
हाँ सर, मेरा सवाल ये है, जैसे 5 साल की जो योजना होती है, इसके लिए जो allocation होता है total रुपए का,
जी.
तो government उसको किस तरीके से खर्च करती है?
जी, government जैसे मैंने बताया था कि government एक approach तैयार करती है, जो total plan outlay बनाती है government. उसके बाद वो जो थ्रस्टिंग एरिया है, अगर आप 12th ईयर प्लान की अप्रोच देखेंगे तो उसमें आप ये देखेंगे कि जो राइट नाउ हमारे पास थ्रस्ट एरिया है जहां पर हमें सबसे ज़्यादा उस ग्रांट के एलोकेशन की ज़रूरत है, हम उसमें स्पेसिफिक दिखाते हैं. जैसे सपोज अगर हमारा पॉवर्टी एलिवेशन के लिए ज़्यादा थिंक ओवर है तो हम मैक्सिमम परसेंटेज पॉवर्टी एलिवेशन के लिए देते हैं. जैसे आपने अभी ड्यूरिंग द मेरे लेक्चर में देखा होगा कि हर प्लान ने एक स्पेसिफिक गोल सेट किया हुआ था. जनरल गोल्स तो हैं, सुविधाएं देना, सोशल सर्विसेज देना, ये सब जनरल गोल्स हैं, लेकिन हम एक स्पेसिफिक गोल्स भी डिसाइड करते हैं कि किसमें ज़्यादा थ्रस्ट है उस चीज़ की. अभी अगर अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट की स्थिति ज़्यादा खराब है तो हमारा मोर फोकस्ड एरिया रहता है कि हम अपना अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट करें. नाउ ए डेज हम लोग अपनी इकोनॉमी को और वाइड करना चाहते हैं. आज के जो इश्यूज़ हैं वो ये है कि FDI को हम कितना अनुमति दे रहे हैं हमारे देश में आने के लिए, हम कैसे अपनी इकोनॉमी को और बड़ा कर सकते हैं जिससे कि हमारे पास और कंट्रियों के ट्रेड भी शुरू हो जाएं. तो टोटल उनका जो प्लान अप्रोच रहता है ग्रांट को एलोकेशन का, वो थ्रस्ट एरिया पे रहता है जो करंट सिचुएशन पे डिपेंड करता है कि हमारे समय इस समय कौन सी करंट सिचुएशंस हैं या कौन से वो करंट थ्रस्ट एरिया हैं जहां हम ग्रांट का ज़्यादा एलोकेशन डिप्लोमेट कर सकते हैं.
सर आई एम श्योर दैट
आई होप यू आर सेटिस्फाइड.
Yes. Oh yes, sir. Okay. The call has been disconnected, and we can continue with the discussion.
Okay. Fine. So we are discussing the sixth plan. Also marked the beginning of the economic liberalisation. Price controls were eliminated, and ration shops were closed. This led to increase in food prices and increase cost of living. As you seen, Pradhan Mantri, jab Rajiv Gandhi elected hue the, they are more focused about the industry development. family planning also was expanded in order to prevent overpopulation. More prosperous areas of India adopted family planning more rapidly than less prosperous areas, which continue to having a high birth rate. So, industrial development ke hisab se, jaise jaise wo period badh raha tha, approaches hamari usi area ki taraf shift hoti ja rahi thi. When you seen from 1950 to 1906 plan approach, then you find every plan had changed their specific object. Even the general objective of poverty alleviation and the some industrial development are same, but every plan have some specific outlay, some specific objective, some specific process to achieve their objectives. So these are the six plans. In next lecture, we can continue the rest of the plans, the 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th, 11th and the 12th plan approach. That we are now process, we have now 12th plan is from 2012 to 2017. What were the targeted we have set, let we discuss in the next lecture. So here the outlay till 6th plan 1980-85. And the what the development as we discussed the, for the some renowned names, Hirakund, Bhakra Dagar dams were introduced, UGC you can see at that time. So here is your, if you have any ask okay. Any question please.
Okay, thank you so much sir for the very well structured presentation. And with the little time left, I would probably like to ask you a question that when the first 5-year plan was formulated, say it was put into action by Jawaharlal Nehru, yeah, by his government. So, the 5-year plan, was it included in the constitution? Was it sanctioned?
Yeah, it's the, when you can see that at the time of Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru was established a planning commission of India with the government constitution in 1950.
Okay.
And now the planning commission established a systematic plan approach. In the first, you can see the process where we are not aware about the process of the how can planning commission deals.
Right.
But now after get the 11th plans over, now we are in position that how to plan in a very systematic way and how to approach in a very systematic appropriate manner. But the situations and the conditions may be a different manner.
Right.
At that time we are we had suffering about the partition.
Yes.
At that time sometimes we are we had suffering about the war prospects. So the condition may be a different, but the systematic plan approach, you can say the goal is also a same, our India's national growth.
Okay sir.
Every plan in the consolidated way, you can ask about the objective of the every planning every plan, they are same.
Right.
We are trying to our economy in the high priority, we are trying to achieve a high national growth, which is the sign of national indicator of,
right,
of any our country.
Okay.
So okay, the plan, so objective may be a different, but the approaches we are the same.
Okay, thank you so much, awesome, sir. So friends, today we discussed the development and planning in India, and we have reached up till the 6th 5-year plan,
sure,
and we will discuss more in the subsequent lectures, of course, tomorrow. So, thank you, sir, for being here, and
thank
we
you
would like to see you soon. And thank you, friends, for watching. We encourage more questions, and have a wonderful day to all of you.